Waking Up with...
Shivraj Prashad, your host on Good Morning Grammar. Now this show is really all about you. If you hear someone using poor grammar, pronunciation, or just enunciating ideas poorly, instead of being rude and correcting them, just turn them over to our Good Morning Grammar experts.
Now it's time for
Words on Wednesday with Preeti Singh.
You've heard about various Indianisms on this show over some excellent episodes, including earlier this week. But it's not just Indians who use weird expressions or incorrect words. There are a number of phrases and words that many people around the world also get horribly wrong. Some of these unfortunately have to do with basic incorrect spelling, but most are either a product of incorrect language translations or the use of similar sounding words. In fact, it was a discussion that Shivraj had with another grammar enthusiast on LinkedIn that piqued my interest to give you some examples. Most people I know, barring my journalist friends, would have spelled that as P-E-A-K-E-D. And that's the problem. Many people have never even heard of peak, P-I-Q-U-E. Unless, of course, you're a random fan of football like me and of the Spanish team or Barca in particular and know Gerard Piqué. Peak is a mountaintop. P-I-Q-U-E peak, as a noun, is a feeling of irritation or resentment, and peaked then becomes a verb that also means arousing interest or curiosity. And if you think you can mix the two up, especially in written communication, ha, you have another thing coming. Oh yes, that's another one. It's not thing with a G. It's another think coming with a K. The problem with many of these errors is that they almost sound like you could get away with it, right? Like first come, first serve. People often forget to put the D. First serve without the D is okay for a game of tennis. But if you're thinking of a free buffet, then the serve without the D means you will have to serve. And no, you will not be entertained first by grammar enthusiasts, no matter how early you arrive to be served. That's a 180 degree turnaround in meaning, right? Now that is another one that just gets on my nerves, when people use 360 degrees to explain a complete transformation instead of the correct 180. The first, 360 degrees, is a circle. The second represents a straight line. I mean, you're actually saying that you've come full circle if you say 360 degrees, back where you started, like you never even moved. Instead of working hard or running to get to the exact opposite end of perhaps a finite straight line, all 180 degrees of it. Like you would run from an argumentative mother-in-law. And while we're on the subject, here's another common mistake people make. While you have but one mother-in-law, you may have multiple sisters or brothers-in-law. Not sister-in-laws or brother-in-laws. Just remember here, the law of the rule remains the same. The number of people is what is plural. And while we're discussing plurals, assigning multiple people tasks to divvy up a piece of work to finish it faster is not to divide and conquer. To divide and conquer actually means to create strife or dissent in order to maintain control over a group of people, especially your subordinates. I'm hoping this episode serves as an appetizer that whets your appetite for more. Now, appetizers are not only liquids that are supposed to whet your appetite, but curtain raisers to the main event as they whet your appetite for more. W-H-E-T, which means to sharpen. And when you leave a place of work, you do not take mementos from it. Memento, in fact, isn't even a word. It's memento. M-E-M-E-N-T-O. I suggest taking un momento, or one moment, to think about the correct vowel to use here before you thank someone for that thoughtful reminder. Now, don't say you could care less if something doesn't bother you, because the correct word to use here is you couldn't care less. I, for one, could care less, but I don't, especially since Shivraj tells me my episodes are at least being heard. So I must end by saying that this is truly heart-touching. Oops, I meant heart-warming for me to hear. I touch my heart when I say this. Keep listening and I'll see you next week.
It's easy to connect with me on Twitter or Instagram. My handle is the same on both. Truth About Nobody. That's TRUTHABTNOBODY. I also have a podcast called The Good Comms Podcast with Preeti Singh, in which I share bite-sized nuggets to help you improve your verbal and non-verbal communication skills. I'd love to connect with you on LinkedIn as well. Till then, see you next Wednesday for a word with me on Good Morning Grammar.
I hope what you heard was useful, but we'd love to hear from you as well. You too can feature on any episode by sending in your request or feedback with a voice message on WhatsApp on +91 962 547 5442 or via email at shivraj@brevis.in. We'd be happy to read out your message here or even play it on an entire Friday special episode. Have a good day and stay tuned for another fresh episode of Good Morning Grammar.